study cast new doubts about the effectiveness of the popular and pricey cholesterol drug Vytorin.
But first, we've come a long way since a diagnosis of HIV amounted to a death sentence. But in the 1980s, AIDS devastated all levels of society. Elizabeth Glazer, wife of Paul Michael Glazer, star of the TV series Starsky and Hutch, contracted the AIDS virus after a blood transfusion in 1981. She unknowingly passed it on to her two children. The Glazers spoke about living with HIV in an interview 18 years ago with Ed Bradley on 60 Minutes.
Our doctor said, don't tell anyone. The world is not ready for your family.
We experienced varying degrees of people saying they couldn't be close to us, their kids couldn't play with our kids.
It was 1986 when the Glazers learned that Elizabeth and their two-year-old Jake had HIV after daughter Ariel was diagnosed with full-blown AIDS. Antibiotics didn't help. Desperate, the Glazers got their hands on the new miracle drug, AZT.
For 3 months, she hadn't spoken a word, and after 3 weeks on intravenous AZT, I walked into her room and she said, good morning, Mom, I love you.
But it was too late. Even with AZT, Ariel died. Elizabeth and Paul channeled their anger at losing their child to fighting for the thousands of children without a voice.
Today, I am here because it's a matter of life and death.
Elizabeth and two friends started the Pediatric AIDS Foundation, lobbying Washington,
good to see you,
recruiting a former president, and holding fundraisers. From the age of 8, Jake began taking AZT and a second HIV drug, and he did well. But his fearless mother, who helped change the face of AIDS, lost her battle in 1994. Paul never got HIV, and Jake grew up close to his father, away from the press. And in what some may consider a miracle, Jake remains symptom-free to this day, the luck of a genetic mutation he and his father share. 4 years ago, doctors told Jake he could stop taking the drugs. Jake Glazer first spoke with People magazine in their latest edition, which is on newsstands now, and he joins us this morning exclusively for his first TV interview. Good morning, Jake.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for being here. You look great.
Thank you.
You know, you look exactly like your dad. You're like a mini Starsky without all the hair.
That's what people have been telling me. When the article came out, they all said the photos looked like my dad. So it's a good compliment. I like it.
You're 23 now. Mm-hmm. Why, after all these years of silence, did you decide to start talking about living with HIV?
At the age of 23, it's pretty amazing to look back on the life that I've lived and where my family has come from and where I've come from. And also looking at this gene, this beautiful gene that my father has passed on to me, which has allowed me to live so healthy with the virus. It's given me an opportunity to A, live with the virus, and B, not be affected by it, and be able to carry the voice of so many children, so many people around the world that necessarily don't have the ability to travel and give a voice.
This beautiful gene, you call it. It's mm-hmm. called CCR5. It means you no longer have symptoms and you no longer take medication.
Correct.
That's unbelievable. Do you think that maybe that gene mutation could be the key to finding a cure for this?
Possibly, yeah. It's it's a wonderful positive defect, which
absolutely.
It's pretty crazy to me to think that my father was the one that carried this and passed it on to me, and he just by happenstance married my mother. But I really do think that it could lead to huge breakthroughs for the medical community.
Unfortunately, your mother and your sister weren't so lucky. They didn't have this mm-hmm. gene. You lost your mother when you were 10, your sister when you were 3. How does such a little boy deal with such a big blow?
I definitely didn't deal with it well. Mm-hmm. When I was younger, at that age, at 10 years old, it was pretty much just a full effort on my part to run away. I didn't want nothing to deal with it. I didn't want to deal with my family. I didn't want to deal with my life. And I was a rebellious child. Who isn't? But, it's...
Would you say it's easier, like when you talk to kids now on behalf of the Pediatric AIDS Foundation, mm-hmm. do you think it's easier being a kid with HIV or AIDS now than it was when you were a kid?
Oh, definitely. Definitely. My family went through a bunch of struggles as far as enrolling me and my sister in preschools. That was a very big issue. Even hanging out with friends, being out of sight of parents, some parents would get very scared for their children. Nowadays, it's a whole different world, and I really do. I love speaking to people about it, and I'm very proud to say that, I do live with it, and hopefully I can help as many people as I can with what my mother and father have given me.
And you live a normal life as an adult, for example? You date?
Complete, yes, for sure.
And does that question come up when you're dating with girls you date?
The question never really comes up. I'm usually the one to bring it up.
Oh.
Yeah, it's important to me. I know how important it is to other people to have honesty and have that information up front. You know, my track record is good so far. No one's freaked out on me. No one's turned a cold shoulder. So it's been nice.
Your mom unknowingly passed this on to you and your sister. Do you worry about that when you have children?
Not at this point, really. You know, the foundation, all the great work we've been doing at the Elizabeth Glaser Pediatric AIDS Foundation, we've developed a medication called Nevirapine, which has greatly reduced the transmission of mother-to-child transmission of the virus, which is absolutely beautiful. And, you know, with more progression in the medical community and what we're doing with research, I don't see why anybody living with HIV couldn't have a family of their own.
I love it. Let's end it on that note. The foundation obviously has done so much already. Mm. And with you at the helm, we'll do more.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jake. Great meeting you.
You as well.
Now back to Dave. He's in Miami with another check of the weather. Hi, Dave.
All right, Maggie. Great story. You know what? We're going to start out.